Hi everybody, we're down here at beautiful Manly Foreshore. Hey, now we're going to look at all the open water plus this little zone here. Let's have a look. Let's wave to the open water. Excellent. Hey, that's Amy and Erin there, just to introduce. They're helping me do something. But now, if you look, we're at the intertidal zone. So the intertidal zone, no water here at the moment. But when the water comes in, what happens? They will tickle Amy and Erin's toes. Let's have a look at this. I wonder if you can join Tickle the Toes. As the water comes in further, it'll start to tickle their knees. They're getting a bit worried. Look at their faces. As it comes in further, it will tickle their tummy. And even further up to their shoulders. Oh, they're getting worried. The water's keeping coming in and they could eventually be underwater. So that's when the water comes in with the tides. But every time it goes in, sometime later it's got to go out. So as it's going out, oh, they can breathe again. Coming down, tickling their shoulders, tickling their tummies, down to their knees and back to their toes, and we're in the intertidal zone again.
Junior scientist, there's an animal that loves to live here, but it's not here at the moment. Right now, it's in the open water. But when the tide comes up and it tickles our neck, what is it? Oh, it's a stingray. But where does it live? Maybe it's down here. Look, junior scientist. I think I found where it rests when it's in the intertidal zone. Oh, look what I found. What is it? It's a crab. What a wonderful little shore crab. Now, it looks really interesting. It's got hairs all over its legs. And look, it's really hard on the outside. It's kind of like its skeleton. Where's your skeleton? My skeleton, that's inside. But a crab skeleton, well, it's on the outside. I wonder if you know what the outside skeleton of a crab is called. It's a big scientific word called an exoskeleton. I wonder why it has an exoskeleton. Maybe it's to protect itself when it's really, really in danger so it doesn't get squished. And guess what? Shore crabs have lots and lots of legs. All right, everybody, guess how many legs does a shore crab have? Is it 2, 4, no, 12. Let's count them together. All right, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 legs. Who knew a shore crab had 10 legs? Wow. So a crab loves to live on the shore when the tide's out. Guess where it was hiding? Under a rock. So I think if I'm being a really good junior scientist, I might put it back right where it came from, back in its habitat, back under a rock.
There are so many types of crabs in Moreton Bay. You've already seen a shore crab, but there are so many others. I wonder what we might find now. I'm going to have a look in this puddle because I think I can see a moving shell. Can you see it too? You've got to be really patient when you're a scientist. You don't want to scare the animals away.
Wow.
Is that what I think it is? Yep, you got it. It's a hermit crab. A hermit crab's different to a shore crab because it can come in and out of its home. Wow, it's got an exoskeleton as well, but it's not as hard as a shore crab, so it needs a bit of extra protection. Did you know they can actually crawl out of their home and find a new one when they get too big? Pretty amazing.
Junior scientists, there's shells everywhere. I hadn't even noticed before. Look, it's the same color as its habitat, brown, just like the mud. I think it's called a mud whelk. And a mud whelk gets all of its food from the mud. And look at its external features. It has a, you guessed it has a shell. Really hard. I'm being very gentle though, as all good junior scientists would be. Because look, we know it's a mud whelk and not a hermit crab because there's no legs inside. It's just a big squishy foot. All right, now, junior scientists, look at them all. Can you count them all? There are so many everywhere. No wonder I didn't see them before because they were the same color. Oh, what's that word? Camouflage, that's right. So they're camouflaged into their habitat. And also, I know how to put it down nice and carefully. Do you? I don't just drop it, do I? No, I very carefully place it down and turn it so the door is facing the ground. And then I say, thank you.
We've seen animals on the Intertidal Zone today. But here, look, I've also found a plant. This is called a mangrove tree, and it's special because it can survive in a saltwater intertidal zone habitat. All these spiky things you can see on the ground, they're its roots. They're called pneumatophores. Think of them like snorkels. They help the mangroves to get oxygen and breathe because trees are living things, just like animals. Lots of animals also like to live within the pneumatophores.
We hope that you've enjoyed exploring the open water and intertidal habitats with us today. It's been so much fun and we've had such a great time. We hope that it's inspired you to become
champions for the bay!
Thank you for joining us on the Habitat Heroes program. We look forward to when you can join us on board Inspiration, our boat out on Moreton Bay, and when you can join Amy and Erin on the foreshore for some more discovery and exploration. Thank you for being such wonderful junior scientists.